Now, I guess you're here because you're a keen learner about Boustead. You're keen to find out more about what is going on with Boustead itself. Simply because Boustead, as well as its unit, Boustead Projects, the share price has came down significantly over the last few days. Now, I'm going to give you my personal take on things, as well as sticking to facts, because right now, things are still resolving. So sticking to facts, you won't spread false information. Or in any case, if you're keen to learn a key learning lesson about investing, then stick towards the end. I'll share with you what you need to look out for. So the key part about why Boustead as well as Boustead Project came down in terms of share prices because of this. Boustead Project's unit has been hauled to court for allegedly using unmanned drones illegally. They are due to appear in state courts in August 27, and they're facing 24 charges for flying a small unmanned aircraft in 2019 and 2020. Now, if you look further in that article, you realize that they are unable to quantify the potential financial impact yet. So that's why I want to do a curious search, just to share with you some findings. This article over here is in November 2019. CNN reported that tougher penalties for drone offenses. So if you are a hobby drone flyer, be very careful. You need permits because these things can crash into things. This can create privacy issues and stuff. So drones, if you have one, fly it very carefully also. So in this article, we learn also that there's regulation for flying drones. And this has been implemented in already with regulation. So maximum fines looks to be 50,000, 100,000. So if we were to press on this hyperlink to see more details of a court case, realize that this particular gentleman has been fined $2,000 for flying his drone without a permit. So would this be good estimates as to what Boustead Projects will face? I don't know. But they are facing multiple charges. And again, a personal liability and a corporate liability may be different also. So legal-wise, let's not jump to conclusions too quickly. The key part that we should try to understand is what kind of impact is it going to have on Boustead, which is a company that, you know, I suggested could be one of the best dividend stocks for 2021. If we were to look in terms of this summary table, you realize that each division brings in certain profit levels, correct? And 2021 was a fantastic year for Boustead Projects because they divested assets. Let's use for simplicity 2020 numbers. You realize that the real estate side, the profit level isn't that fat also. So will there still be profits for real estate segment? I'm not too sure yet. But again, what I always love about Boustead is their geospatial segment. The energy engineering side might see a recovery, that's a good play on things. But all in all, I think Boustead's profit levels could be affected if the charges were to be proven correct. So moving forward, if there's new developments in this case itself, I'll keep you abreast with a quick update like this. Then back to the key learning point. You see, this reinforces the fact, whatever research you do in a stock, you cannot prevent shocks from happening. Businesses face risk all the time. This is not unprecedented, a fine. For example, BP, British Petroleum, when they had an oil spill, that also caused them to face a very, very big fine. So businesses are always doing their operations with risk. And when fines like this happen, shocks to share price could also take place. What you need to do as an investor is decide whether this shock is a one-off shock, whether it fundamentally impacts the business or not. That determines whether you should keep the stock or sell the stock or see it as buying opportunities. So this is really where you need to exercise your investor acumen. So having left off as that, I would also like to dismiss certain things that you see on YouTube. Certain YouTubers always use thumbnails that I'm going all in in this. I think that's very naive, that's very silly. Something that looks very clickbaity, but it's actually very bad in terms of investment practice. As a small investor, you can always decide how much you want to get invested. You don't need to be greedy. Even if you see a great opportunity, you should keep certain disciplines to things to protect yourself, correct? So for my own, I always suggest for a particular stock, don't have it more than 20% of your portfolio. I think that is a good discipline to have. Because shocks like this can happen and you don't want yourself to face too much of a financial impact as a small investor. So hopefully this message catches you at the right time. If that, let me also invite you to smash on subscribe. If there's new developments onto this case itself, I'd like to share this with you on this channel and see you more often. So with that, I'll sign off. Take care and goodbye.